Individuals with developmental disabilities are the heart of Koinonia. Each one is unique and has a different story to tell. Koinonia Homes started in 1974, but it really began a year before that with Sister Mary Charles.
It's been well over 20 years since Joanne came to live at Leanne's, so we've been part of this family well over 20 years. When we take her home for a visit, she'd say, "I'm only going one night, and then I come back home." So this has been her home. She has loved it from the day she first came here for respite care.
Leanne's was donated to Koinonia in 1973 by Leo Schmidt and his family. It was named after the first letter of each family member. Today, Leanne's is one of 20 homes in the Koinonia family.
My clients demand and expect a lot. We're just constantly going. 5:30 in the morning, we're up doing meds and breakfast, getting out to 5 different programs, doctor's appointments.
Koinonia's mission is partnering with people who have developmental disabilities to achieve healthy, fulfilling, and rich lives. It's a partnership because every person we serve has their own unique potential.
We run normal lives just like everybody else. We eat normal. We think almost normal. So it just gives us a chance.
From 1980 to 1990, Koinonia continued to open new group homes. Each of our homes is located in residential neighborhoods throughout Cauga County. We want the individuals we serve to feel they are part of our family and part of their community.
Etika's, very active within her home. She participates in the walking club. She participates in the SOAR program. She does quite a bit of, enriching activities.
During 1990, Koinonia also expanded its services to develop supported living programs.
Sometimes I help them cook, sometimes. Like that was a tuna fish casserole he had made the other night, so he just eats off that. But sometimes I'll take them out to eat.
In 2001, Koinonia merged with another provider, and at that time, not only did we acquire new homes, but we also acquired a foster program. 5 years later, we opened our Adult Day Support and Habilitation Center, Koinonia Enterprises. The center offers programs to individuals during the day and in the evening. It houses our vocational services program.
It was an opportunity to prove to myself that I can get out into the community and work. I do handmade jewelry. I make bracelets and necklaces and earrings.
This job gives me both the paperwork and the front desk work, along with helping other people with their work. I love talking to people, I love seeing people, I love helping people.
Koinonia continues to work to meet the community need. In 2008, we added 9 homes for 65 individuals to our care. The additional 150 staff members brings our human resources close to 500 people.
The direct care staff is so involved with the clients and they care so much. I think that is probably the most beautiful thing that makes us as a family very comfortable.
We have a high standard, and we're not willing to compromise.
Sister Charles was a fighter for the cause, and she worked very hard to make sure that people with disabilities were received the services and the respect and the rights that they deserved. And Koinonia continues to work on that even today.